Hello friends, I am Mr. Ravindra Bhale Rao and I welcome you to my channel that is English for Learners. Friends, today we are going to study basic sentence structure in English and these are parts of a sentence. But before watching this video, as usual, I request you don't forget to subscribe my channel. Let's see basic parts of a sentence. And these are subject, verb, and object. First one is subject. Subject is the person or thing that does something. In Marathi, we can say that वाक्यातील ज्या भागात व्यक्ती किंवा वस्तूंचा उल्लेख असतो त्या भागाला सब्जेक्ट म्हणतात. इन अ सिंपल सेंटेन्स सब्जेक्ट इज अ नियरली बिगिनिंग इन द सेंटेन्स. साध्या वाक्यामध्ये सब्जेक्ट हा वाक्याच्या सुरुवातीला येतो. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, शी लाईक्स कॅट्स. इन दिस सेंटेन्स शी इज अ सब्जेक्ट. सब्जेक्ट मे बी either noun or pronoun. Let's see next example. Birds are flying in the sky. In this sentence, birds is a subject. Let's see more examples. The hawk soars. The boys laugh. My daughter is a wrestler. Children are tired. In each of these sentences, the subject is a noun, hawk, boys, daughter, and children. Next parts of a sentence is verb. Verb is a word that expresses an action, occurrence, or state of being in the sentence. अर्थात ज्या शब्दातून वाक्यातील कृती अथवा क्रिया व्यक्त होते किंवा जे शब्द वाक्यातील स्थिती व्यक्त करतात त्या शब्दांना वर्ब्स किंवा क्रियापदे म्हणतात. किंवा वाक्याचा अर्थ पूर्ण करण्याकरिता वर्ब आवश्यक असते. क्रियापदाशिवाय ते वाक्य पूर्ण होऊ शकत नाही. अँड दी एक्झाम्पल्स, शी लाईक्स कॅट्स. In this sentence, likes is a verb. More examples. They came to me. He works hard. I made a kite. The underlined words came, works, made. These are verbs. The last one is object. Object, a person or thing that receives the action of a verb. And the example is, she likes cats. The word cats is an object. Objects may be nouns or pronouns. Objects receive the action and usually follow the verb. Let's see more examples. The girls hurled stones. The professor swigged coffee. Gus dropped the iPad. In these sentences, objects are stones, coffee, iPad. All answer the question what. What was hurled? What was swigged? What was dropped? As the following sentences demonstrate, pronouns may also serve as objects. For example, before eating the brownie, Nancy sniffed it. Next example. When I finally found my brother, I kissed him. So in these examples, it and him, these are objects. The common object pronouns are me, you, him, her, it, us, and them. So friends, now you should now be able to identify the main parts of the basic sentence in it, and these are subject plus verb, or subject plus verb plus object. Remember that the subject names what the sentence is about, the verb tells what the subject does or is, and the object receives the action of the verb. Although many other structures can be added to this basic unit, the pattern of subject plus verb or subject plus verb plus object can be found in even the longest and most complicated structures. Practice in identifying subjects, verbs, and objects. For each of the following sentences, decide whether the word in bold is a subject, a verb, or an object. When you are done, compare your answer with those at the end of the exercise. Exercise A, identifying subjects and verbs. For each of the following sentences, decide whether the word in bold print is the subject or the verb. When you are done, compare your responses with the answers on page 2. Friends, I hope you might have liked this video. If you liked it, please share it. If you have any suggestions for me, please write in comment box. Wish you good day. Thank you very much.